You are creating a website where you have to insert number of items. Suppose food items are looking here. The heading is food items. Okay, food items what we have here? Number, suppose A it is butter. On B it is ghee. On C it is something else. Suppose we want listing like this, food items A, B, C or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever you want it. We can do those things in HTML easily. We have supporting tags for creating a list, that is known as listing tags. Tags are of two types. Number one, ordered list, like this, A, B, C or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, numbering menu. Trying to get. Okay. Number second is unordered list. Okay. Ordering is not important. Just you have to create one listing. There we use this unordered list. So come on the point now. Unordered list. Right now. Unordered list. First of all, it is a container list. So once you open, you will close it. Clear? This is container. Number two, how to write the ordered list, you will write the ordered list inside the body tag. And the syntax for that, under angle bracket, OL. Okay, since it is a container, so you will have to close it also. How to close, I will show you. Now, concentrate on the attribute of OL. Attribute of OL is type. I have written here OL dash, OL space type is equal to A. You want one, you can do it one. You want a small a, you can do a small a. You want to write Roman numbers here, you can put at the place of a, one in Roman number or two, whatever you want. Okay? Second part is unordered list. Unordered, I have already told you, but you don't need order to explain the things. So, unordered list is again a container tag. Syntax to write the order list in the same way inside the body tag UL under angular bracket. Okay? And the attribute of UL is also type. An order list attribute is type. Here I have written under double quotes square. Three types of type you have in unordered list. Other two are is and circle. Now you will ask me how. Again, I am going to show you display. Suppose food items. I can write here food items. This is your display page. Food items. I am here putting one circle. Circle is a lot here. So I will write it into circle. Circle, suppose number one is butter. Again another circle for ghee. Again circle for other one. Another circle for other one. This way, here you find no 1, 2, 3, no ABCD, no ordering. Okay, so this is known as ordered list. But the main point here you have to remember how to write the tag of ordered list, how to write the tag of unordered list. That is UL, that is UL. With this tags, one helping tags is also there. Now, I am going through one example, then you will come to know how to create these two pages in your website. Okay. One by one, I will go with the first, I am going with the ordered list. Start the coding and scale up. Close it, then head, then title, then the name. What you are going to display? Ordered and unordered list. Ordered and unordered list. Okay, your title is over, close this title. Now close the head. Clear? Now starting the body part. in a simple way we can create this particular page. Okay, so what is first food item? You can use the H1 because the heading we want in a bigger text. So right, so my H1 is very big, so start here with H3, a medium level tab. Okay, H3 here actually will be food item. Then close the H3. Over. Now we are moving. This is order, so we will write here over. Clear? Suppose you don't want A, B, C, D, whatever, then by default something else will come over there. Then we put over there. But I am defining here type. So with over you will put in one space, giving one space. After that you will write type is equal to. Suppose I am writing A. Because A is mentioned here. I will write A and double close it. I told you one helping tag is here with ULM, OL also. That helping tag is nothing but LI. It is also a container tag. LI means the listing. Now I am going to do the listing. First item is butter. LI, right here, butter. Then close this side because this LI is a container. Close. Okay. Second, ghee. Right here, ghee. Then close it. Okay. Third, again something is here, LI. Write that. Then close it. Suppose your listing is over. But keep in your mind that your OL is open state. When it will get closed? After writing the listing, you will close this. Alright. Have closed. Now this page is ready. What I needed? I have to close now body and I have to close this rest table also. So close body. And close STM. Okay? Your websites are ready. You can type the whole things in your notepad, save it, and give the file name.html. Then you will see the result will be like this. Okay? So now, right now I will explain about this OL. Now the question, what about unordered list? Unordered list, do nothing in the same page because you are practicing. In the same page, wherever you have written OL, first make those things UL. UL, okay? Here LI will be same, listing will be same, no issue. Only type you have to change. What you will do with the typing? Three things I have told you. A square disk. You will put here. A square disk and circuit. Anyone of that you will put here. Suppose I am putting circuit. Okay? Circuit will be closed. Everything will be same. Again, UL you have opened. Here you will, what you will do? You will close the UL only, not OL. So you will write here. UL. Now close. Now your display will be like this. In the web browser, it will be like this. 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 Okay? If you are interested, you can put your name that it is created by you. So, before closing this body, write here your name. Whatever your name, suppose X, Y, Z. You can type your name, it will get displayed over here. Whatever you will type, it will get displayed over here. So today I have hopefully I have come over with this your listing tag, that is unordered list and ordered list. Okay, this is very useful for class 8 as well as for class 10. Because these things are surely coming into the examination. So prepare well. Deal on some other tags like table and so many are here. I will deal on some.